Hi friends, welcome. I hope that everyone is doing well today. I'm gonna go ahead and share my screen so that we can get started into this flash fire Q&A. Persistence is great, kind of following into the weekend thing. First, I wanna say hello. So if you're watching me live or you're watching the recorded version, if you just pop into the comments, hello. I would love to connect with each one of you and say hello back to you. I love meeting new people. Then the next thing is that I want you guys to tell me, here's my question of the day. What are you looking forward to this fall? Because, you know, summer is on, hopefully, the waning end. I hate to say hopefully because I really do enjoy summer. I don't enjoy the 100-degree weather, but I really do enjoy summer. But I also like the fall. In Tennessee, we have four seasons as opposed to Houston, where we kind of have like two or one sometimes. But I would love for you, if you got it at the moment, just to pop into the comments what you're looking forward to this fall. Me, I'm looking forward to sports. I'm looking forward to college football. I'm looking forward to college basketball. I'm looking forward to the Memphis Grizzlies starting back. I have a new profound love of sports after this past year and any opportunity I can. I love my city, the city of Memphis, and just so happy to be back and just all the great things that are going on here. So I would love to know what you're looking forward to this fall. Now, I had a great quote that I saw yesterday, and I actually saw it on Instagram. And I didn't have time to make the little graphic for it. But what I want to tell you is, and actually it's a basketball player. He grew up in Memphis. KJ Lawson is his name. And he graduated from Hamilton High School. He went to college at Memphis, Tulane in Kansas. He now plays professionally. And I believe he was playing in Las Vegas this summer for the NBA Summer League for the Boston Celtics. He's one of three or four brothers. I forget how many. But just an incredibly talented family. He's 25, and he's had some ups and downs through college and afterwards. Another story for another day. But he said something on an interview yesterday, and I watched it, and he said, "I don't count the days. I make the days count." And I thought, that's just such a great philosophy of life. And that's what my Flash Fire Friday going into the weekend talk is about today, is don't count the days, make the days count. Whatever that means to you. We all are in places where we may not like what's going on around us. The class that I taught this morning was a job search class. A lot of the people are unemployed. And no, that may not be great. You may be counting the days until you get employed. But what you can do to turn that around and adhere to that quotation is, what can you do today to make today count? Whether it is doing more action in job search, whether it is self-care, whether it is making time for family, whatever that is, how can you make today count? Because so many times I think that we sit here and we dwell on the negative aspects or what we're lacking. And we're waiting for that day. We're counting the days until the good thing starts. You've got something to look forward to, which we should have something to look forward to, but not when we forsake taking care of what's happening today, every day. When you end every day, it's a day you cannot get back. It's time you cannot get back. We're all on a ticking clock. Anything can happen. And so it's important that you take care of what's today and you make today as important as possible. Do as many things as possible to make today count. And that's really what he was talking about, is so many times we sit here and we're just trying to kill time until something great happens. But we're missing out on making something great happen right now, in this moment, in this time. And that was actually one of the reasons I chose to leave Houston and move back to Tennessee. I missed my family that I had left. I you may not know, my mother passed away in 2016. I have aunts, I have cousins left. I missed my family. I missed my friends that I've known for 30 plus years. They're like family to me. I miss them. And I'm going to be the first to admit, I also miss sports. I miss Memphis sports. So I asked myself in November of 2019, I was actually at an event. I was shooting an event, a gala. And I was photographing all these people up on the dance floor dancing and having a great time and living life. And I just realized I'm watching people live their lives and I wasn't doing it. Why was I making a future for myself in a city that I did not enjoy that much? It wasn't me. I'm not a Houstonian. Although I was for 16 years, it's just not me. And so I made that decision that I wasn't going to waste any more time doing something or being somewhere that did not light me up. And so that's when I made the decision that I was going to relocate back to Tennessee. Best decision I ever made. Do I miss Houston? Yes. Would I like to go back and visit? Yes. But I want to take every day and make the most out of it. Even during the pandemic, I tried to do that. And even now, I try to do that every day. So I hope that you take KJ's quote, "I don't count the days, I make the days count," important, and put it up. Wherever you see something every day, put it up and try to live that motto and bring something important into your life every day. Okay, let's go back. So you did that one. So let's now go into our first question of the day, which is, this was sent in by someone. What is your favorite camera lens to use? Okay, so my favorite camera lens is going to be surprising to you guys. So my favorite camera lens is actually a 50 millimeter prime lens. I actually started using that, and for photographers that are probably watching this, you're probably going to like freak out. I don't really care. I started using a 50 millimeter prime lens, one because it was $199. It was really cheap. I loved how it blurred the background. I loved the look of it. And for 2 to 3, maybe 4 years, that was the only lens I really used. I had a zoom lens. I think it was like maybe a 35 to 70 or something like that. It wasn't a really long lens. And I did use that occasionally, but I love the 50 millimeter lens. And then the next lens that I started using was a 35 millimeter prime lens. And that's actually my go-to lens for anything now. Again, I'm sure photographers out there are gasping right now. I don't care. It is my lens. I like it. It's the way I shoot. I make it work for me. And that is all that matters. My clients love it. I take great photographs. I take great portraits. That's all that matters. I don't care about anybody else's opinion. So that, but what I will also tell you, because I get asked a lot of times, what camera do you think is the best to buy? I'm going to say whatever camera you think is best for what you need it for. Now, that being said, the best camera to have is the one you have in your hand. A lot of times, I'm actually shooting with my iPhone. Now, if I take my professional camera out, it is a Canon 5D Mark III. But there are so many things on it I don't even use. I don't even know what they do. Because I don't need to use all of those little gadgets. You don't need all those gadgets. You need something that takes a good sharp picture. You can get great lighting. And if that's an iPhone, then so be it. Most of the time when I'm traveling or I'm out doing stuff, my iPhone is what I use to take pictures of. It's what I use video with. And it just is. I make it work. So if you're looking for a camera, to have a big professional camera, unless you are a professional photographer taking pictures that people are going to pay you for, you don't need big fancy cameras. The cameras that they make today, especially under $500, have great characteristics. And you just need to find the ones that you like, that you're comfortable with. That's all that matters. And then use the lens, try out different lenses. You can actually rent lenses. I think borrowlenses.com is one of those. try out lenses, see what you like, and go from there. That's my two cents. That's my two cents for today. Okay, so now let's go back into the presentation. So let's go to the next question of the day. Or actually, no, where are you watching from today? That's what I want to know next. Where are you watching me from today? So if you put that into the comments, why am I asking you to comment? Because it's interacting, you're engaging with me. I want to go back after this live is over or a couple of days, even after it's recorded. If you're watching the recorded version, please pop into the comments and let me know where you're watching from and say hello. I would love to know that. Now, our next question of the day that was sent in is how to get started when I feel so overwhelmed. This was actually a part of my class that I taught this morning. Was we really talked about getting started and how that can feel very overwhelming. And that's true. And I'll be one of the first people to say that I can kind of feel like that as well a lot of times. My advice to you is really just to, one, make sure that whatever it is that you are procrastinating getting started or you feel overwhelmed about, make sure it's something that you want to do. And then sit down and really think about the components of it. Because so many times we'll say, oh, I want to read more, but we don't have a plan. Or I want to travel more, but you don't actually sit down and think about where you want to travel. Now, I actually put this into fruition this past weekend, last weekend. I've been saying, I want to travel more. I want to take little bitty trips every weekend, but I never really do anything about it. I've got ideas in my head, but I don't really plan anything. And so last weekend, I was like, I'm going to sit down and look at my schedule from now until the end of December, until the end of this year, and I'm going to look down and see what weekends I have available because I'm a season ticket holder for football now. So I'm going to sit down and see what weekends I have available to go out and do something. And so I went and did that. And then I was like, okay, what are cities that I could actually go to in a day? So I could drive there, do some things, and drive back and not have to stay overnight. I looked at those cities and I wrote a list down. And then I wrote a list down of where could I go over a weekend, drive, spend the night, do some things, and drive back that wasn't like 10 hours. So I wrote a list of those things down. And then I went and looked at the weekends and I was like, okay, which ones do I want to do first? And then I wrote them in. And I use sticky notes on every weekend. Now, I've planned out. So there's no excuse now. And now it's not so overwhelming. I'm not like, oh my God, how long is it going to take me? Where do I want to go? I've already done part of the process. Now, yes, a weekend may come up and I may be like, I'm going to stay. There's things in Memphis I want to do, or there's things here I want to do, or it's a really bad weather weekend. I can move that to another date. But the thing is, I've actually put in process what I have the option to do now. And now it's not so overwhelming. So having that type of plan, sitting down and breaking something apart is really, really helpful in helping you get over that overwhelmed feeling. And then put on those blinders and do one thing at a time. So for me, I could focus on maybe I want to go to Nashville one weekend. Maybe I want to go to Nashville in September. Then I can just focus on that and do that weekend. And I'm putting things into place. And the same thing for you. If you're in job search, if you're trying to market your business, the biggest thing is just to sit down and plan out 1 week or just the month and then figure out what you're going to do every day of that week or every week of that month, and sit down and then put the blinders on and focus on what those steps are right then. But don't wait to be perfect, because there is no perfection at all. And the only way you're going to learn is by messing up. The very first wedding I shot was horrible. Okay, I'm just going to be honest. I didn't know what I was doing. I'd never used an off-camera flash. The bride knew that. She hired me anyway because I made her feel comfortable. That's good, because I didn't feel comfortable. And I shot too quickly. My batteries ran out on my flash and I didn't know the settings. It was horrible. She ended up loving the pictures. Bless her heart. I'm going to actually do another shoot with her and her family. But I learned a valuable lesson. Did that keep me from ever shooting weddings again? No. I also always keep an extra entire box of batteries just in case. But I typically don't shoot with a flash anyway. I use natural light. But weddings, I still remember that. Does it keep me from going on and trying again? No. So don't let things that you mess up, it teaches you how to learn. It teaches you how that should be better, how you can make improvements. And we should all be making improvements in our life every single day. We're always a work in progress. So if you remember anything this weekend, it's remembering that you are always going to be a work in progress. And to make sure that you don't count the days, that you make the days count. And I hope that you take that in with you this weekend and really remember that. Don't count the days, make the days count. Okay, guys, have a fantastic weekend and I'll see you next week. If you have questions, you can send me a DM, pop them into the comments below, and I would love to hear what your questions are. Have a great weekend. Bye, guys.